Okay, now we are going to discuss the cue learning algorithm which can be used to show your reinforcement learning, what you have learned in the previous class, in previous lecture. Okay, so here what I'm going to do, I have shown you a diagram over here. Each one is a room. Okay, you have 5 rooms over here, and this outer area is represented as 5. Alright, now these are the doors. You can go from room 4 to room 0. The ultimate goal is you have to reach room number 5. That is the ultimate goal of this entire thing. And how will I reach 5? Or how will the robot reach 5? If it is going from one room to the other, each room can be considered as a state. So here, when I am going from room 4 to room 3, this is one state, this is the next state. Okay? So if it is a correct move, I am going to give a reward. We have games like this. There are a lot of games which are there wherein you will not know how the structure of the different rooms are. You are just pushed into one room and then you have to go to the next room. Sometimes there will be water over there and you literally fall when you open the door. And if you can reach the exit point, then you win the game. That is how the different games are. There are shows, TV shows also like that. So something on similar grounds, this is the agent has to go from any of these rooms to the external world, which is 5. So this entire thing is what we call as 5. Okay? Now I am going to represent this using a graph structure. So a graph structure means that each room is represented as a node. So I have node 1, node 3, node 4, node 2, node 0, node 5. Okay, now I tell you how these arrows are. Okay. So I have 5 nodes, I have represented by 5 different nodes. Now we start with 0. From 0 I can come to room 4 and the other way around is possible. There is only one door over here. So from 0 I can go to room 4 and I can come back to node 0 also. Okay? Next, go to room 1. 1 I can come to 3 and 1 I can go to 5 also. So 1 I can come to 3 and 1 I can go to 5 also. Okay? Next, there are two doors over here. Then we come to 2. From 2 I can come to only 3. So from 2 I can come to only 3. Okay? Both bidirectional. Then from 3 I can go to 4. I can go to 1. 3 I can go to 4. Again 1. Okay? Then from 4 I can go to 0. From 4 I can go to 0. Or I can come outside. Outside is nothing else but 5. So from 4 I can go to 0 or 5. Okay? So this is the representation of this diagram as a graphical structure. Now we have to see how we are going to learn these different states. Okay? Now to learn the different states, we can start with any one of the rooms. Okay? We first, what we do is we represent two matrices over here. One is called as a Q matrix and other one is called as a R matrix. Now R matrix is a reward matrix. Q matrix we will first consider it as 0. All zeros. Initial Q matrix will be all zeros. So your Q matrix will be, how many nodes I have? I have from node 0 to 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Same thing over here. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Initially, the entire matrix is 0. Then we will see how to change. 0, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. This is my initial Q matrix. Then we have to write your reward matrix or your R matrix. So R will be based on the state and the actions. So I have different states. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you have actions. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. minus 1. 0 to 1, no path. So again, minus 1. From 0, where do we have a path? We have a path to only 4. So when there is a path, I will represent it as 0. So from 0 to 4, I will represent it as 0. All the numbers will be minus 1. Okay? Next, I take the node 1. Now from 1, I can come to 3, I can come to 5. Now there is a path to 3 from 1, which I will show it as 0. Okay? There is a path to 5 also, but 5 I will not show as 0 because if it is going from state 1 to 5, 5 is a go state. It has reached the ultimate. So you have to give it maximum rewards for that particular move. So for that, I will give it 100 points. Okay? If it is able to go from state 1 to state 5, it is going to get 100 points. Alright? Otherwise, if there is only a path from one state to other, mark it as 0. So all the others, since okay, then you are just going to mark it as 1. Okay? Next, go to note 2. 2 I have a path to 3, only 3, nothing else. So from 2 to 3, I will show it as 0. All the others will be minus 1. Okay? Then from 3, you have a path to 4, you have a path to 1, you have a path to 2. So 3 to 2, 3 to 4, and 3 to 1. All the others will be minus 1. So this is 3 to 2, 3 to 1 and 3 to 4. Okay? Next, fourth node, 4 you have a path to 3. So for 4 path to 3, I will show it as 0. Now 4 you have a path to 0. 4 to 0, I will show it as 0. 4 I have a path to 5. 5 is a goal state. So I will give it a point of 100 for this. Okay? All the others will be. Then the last one, node 5, 5 can go to 1, 5 can go to 4, both will be 0, but 5 coming back to 5 will be 100. Okay? 5 can go to 1, 5 can go to 4, 5 coming back to 5 will be 100, the rest will be minus 1. So this is your R matrix. Okay? Or your reward matrix. I have given a reward when it is going from one state to the other state. So if there is a path, we give it a value of 0. If there is no path, we write it as minus 1. Okay? Okay. Now, I will just start this portion of it. Now, the formula for this is, for your human algorithm is, Q of state comma action is equal to R. R is the reward. Reward of state comma action plus gamma into, or I write as gamma into maximum of Q of next state, comma all actions. This is the formula we have to follow when we are going to start. Okay? Q of state comma action is equal to R of state comma action plus gamma into Q of maximum of Q of all state comma actions. Next state comma all actions. Now we will assume that, and not the earlier figure, we will assume that we were in state 1. I will just run this first line of place to show. Okay. You can choose any state randomly. Okay. Now I will assume that I am in state 1. So from room number 1 I am starting what is my state? Imagine my initial state is 1. Okay? So, apply the formula. Q of 1, comma, now from 1 to 1 is equal. Okay. Okay, I'll just put a small figure over here. This small figure 1, 3, 5, 4, 0, 2. Okay. Now from state 1, I can either go to state 5 or I can go to state 3. Any one of the two I can do. Okay? Now supposing I take state 3, Q of 1 comma 3. My action is to go to state 3. So it is equal to R of 1 comma 3. The state is 1, action is I am going to state 3 plus gamma into. Gamma can be any value between 0 and 1. Okay, now here I have assumed that gamma is 0.8. Okay? A constant value. Gamma into maximum of Q of now next state. Which is my next state? 1 is my current state. My next state is 3. Okay. So from 3, maximum of next state. Q of 3, comma all actions. From 3, where else can I go? I can go to 1, I can go to 2, I can go to 4, I can go to 5. This is not good. So from 3, I can go to 1, I can go to 2, I can go to 4. So this is my next state. I can go to 1 or I can go to 2 or I can go to 4. You have to look for the Q matrix. Okay? So what is R of 1, comma 3? R of 1, comma 3 is equal to 0 plus 0.8 into maximum of Q of 3 comma 1 is how much? Q matrix. All are zeros in Q matrix. Okay. So it is again 0. So your output here will be 0. Okay. This is if I had gone to state 3. But from state 1 I can go to state 5 also. So now if I take Q of 1 comma 5. What will be the output? It will be R of 1 comma 5 plus 0.8 into maximum of, again same thing, your next state is 5.